Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala rasulihil kareem. Amma ba'd. Fa'a'udhu billahi min ash-shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Inna 'iddata ash-shuhuri 'inda Allahi 12 shahran fi kitabillah. Yawma khalaqa as-samawati wal ard minha arba'atun hurum. ذلك الدين القيم فلا تظلموا فيهن احدا فلا تظلموا فيهن انفسكم وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من احدث في امرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد او كما قال عليه الصلاه والسلام Respected elders, brothers and sisters in Islam, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who creates and chooses whatsoever he wills, because he is the creator, he is the selector. وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has perfect wisdom. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has the knowledge of everything. Al-Alim. It's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has absolute power. Al-Qadir. Out of his infinite knowledge and wisdom, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses some days and months and gives them preference over other. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses among the months four, which he has made sacred. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah At-Tawbah, chapter 9, verse 36, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ 12 شَهْرًا يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ The number of months with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is 12. It was ordained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ On the day he created the heavens and the earth. مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةٌ حُرُمْ Four of them are sacred. ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمْ This is the right religion. فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ So do not do zulum on yourself, do not do wrong on yourself during this month. The Quran does not make mention of the names of this sacred month, but their names have been mentioned in the ahadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Imam Bukhari rahimahullahu ta'ala anhu recorded in his Sahih Bukhari on the authority of Abu Bakr radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam delivered his last khutbah and he said, Inna al-zamana kad istara ka hayatihi yawma khalaqa Allahu al-samawati wal-ard. Time revolves since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. Min al-sanatu isna ashara shahran. The year is of 12 months. منها أربعة حرم four of them are sacred ثلاثة متبالية three consecutive months ذو القعدة وذو الحجة ومحرم ذو القعدة ذو الحجة محرم ورجب and رجب شهر مضر the month of مضر الذي بين جمادي وشعبان which falls between جمادي الثاني and شعبان Dear brothers and sisters, today I would like to share with you some information about the month of Rajab in the light of the Quran and the ahadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Being Muslims, I have no doubt that every one of us is aware of the Islamic month we are in. We are at the end of the sacred month, the month of Rajab, only weeks away from the blessed month, the month of Ramadan. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the months of Rajab and Sha'ban blessed for us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to prolong our life up to the month of Ramadan so that we may benefit from its blessings. Imam Ahmad and Bayhaqi rahimahum Allah ta'ala anhuma recorded in their Sunan that the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on sighting the moon of Rajab used to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. O Allah, make the months of Rajab and Sha'ban blessed for us, and let us reach the month of Ramadan. Because, dear brothers and sisters, the month of Rajab marks the beginning of the spiritual season for every Muslim, ending with Eid al-Fitr. The month of Rajab is the key to the opening month of goodness and blessing, and is deemed to be a prelude to the month of Ramadan, because the month of Ramadan follows the month of Rajab after the intervening month of Sha'ban. Therefore, every Muslim should plan his schedule for the blessed month from now, so that he can spend and so that he can devote himself, he can spend maximum of his time for ibadah during the blessed month of Ramadan. Coming back to the topic, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala singled out 4 months for special merits and status, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to respect them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prohibited us from violating their holiness, from violating their sanctity, from violating their honor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ma'idah, chapter 5, ayah 2, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, la tuhillu sha'air Allah wala shahra al-haram. O you who believe, do not violate the symbols of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nor of the sanctity of the sacred month. When a person violates the rules and regulations set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he spends his life adapting a way and lifestyle other than that the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then he is causing his own destruction, making his way to Jahannam, to the hellfire. وَلَا تُلْقُوا بِأَيْدِيكُمْ إِلَى التَّهْلُكَةِ. Imagine, my brothers and sisters, how merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, and how kind Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. Out of his immense mercy and out of his immense love for his slave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us not to do zulm to ourselves, not to do wrong to ourselves. فَلَا تَظْلِمُوا فِيهِنَّ أَنفُسَكُمْ. That don't do wrong, don't do zulm to yourself. We have to pay attention to the sanctity and to the honor of this sacred month, and we have to stay away from committing sins, especially in these 4 months. Committing sins is haram, is forbidden during all the months and all the times of the year, but it is more forbidden to commit sin during these 4 months, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made these months, this time, sacred. So Rajab is the 7th month in the Islamic lunar calendar, and is one of these 4 sacred months that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made sacred, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to maintain their holiness, to maintain their sanctity. But neither Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nor his Rasul specified any ibadah for the month of Rajab. It is people who have innovated some practices, some rituals for this month, for the month of Rajab. These practices are not supported by the reliable sources of the Sharia, or they are based on unauthentic ahadith. Some, for instance, some people believe that fasting during the month of Rajab, especially on 27th of Rajab, is sunnah, is more virtuous. There are some ahadiths that attribute some reward to the fast of 27th Rajab, but these ahadiths are, according to the scholar of ahadith, very weak and unauthentic. They can't be enough to establish a rule of Sharia. On the contrary, we have a sahih ahadith, we have an authentic ahadith that Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala anhu used to forbid people from fasting during the month of Rajab. In Musannaf, it is recorded on the authority of Kharasha bin al-Harm that he said, I saw Umar bin Khattab smacking the hands of those people who fasted during the month of Rajab until they reached out for food. And he used to say, إِنَّمَا هُوَ شَهْرٌ كَانَ أَهْلُ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ يُعَظِّمُونَ. This is a month which was respected, honored by people in the period of Jahiliyyah, in the period of ignorance. Some people believe that performing Umrah, going for Umrah during the month of Rajab is Sunnah, is more virtuous than doing it in the other month of the year when it has no basis in divine Sharia. Specifying acts of worship, specifying any ibadah at specific times, at times that have not been specified by Sharia, is wrong. No time is to be regarded more better, no time is regarded to be better than other time, especially in occasions, in times, in cases where Sharia gives preference to some ibadah at a certain time. My respected brothers and sisters, don't misinterpret me. Let me clarify the point that any nafil ibadah, whether salah, sawm, umrah, can be performed at any time on any day of the year, except the times and days have been forbidden by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, fasting during the month of Rajab, fasting on 27th of Rajab, going for Umrah during the month of Rajab, are not prohibited themselves. What's prohibited is the belief that fasting during the month of Rajab, or fasting on 27th of Rajab, or going for Umrah during the month is more virtuous than doing it in other months or in other day of the year. With this belief, one should not fast during the month of Rajab. One should not fast on 27th of Rajab. One should not go for Umrah during the month of Rajab. But if somebody does not have these beliefs and he fasts during the month of Rajab, he fasts on 27th of Rajab, or he goes for Umrah during the month of Rajab, and he believes that it's a normal fast, it's a nafil ibadah, like other nafil ibadah, then there is no harm in doing so. It's generally believed that the event of Mi'raj, ascension of the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the heavens, took place on the night of 27th of Rajab. And therefore, some people celebrate this night as Laylatul Mi'raj. Indeed, the event of Mi'raj is one of the most remarkable episodes in the life of our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was called by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he traveled from Mecca to Baitul Muqdis, and from there he ascended to the heavens through the miraculous power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was honored with a direct intent, with a direct contact with his creator at a place where even the angels have no access. In this meeting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enjoined the 5 daily prayers on him. At first, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enjoined 50 prayers, but our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kept going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking him to reduce it until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it 5. So the prayer, the obligatory prayer, are 5, but there are 50 in reward, because every good deed, each good deed is rewarded tenfold. Man ja'a bil hasanati falahu 10 amsalha. No doubt, the night in which this event took place is one of the great nights in the history of this world, but the exact date of this event has not been proven. There are some ahadith that relate this event to the night of 27th of Rajab, but there are other ahadith which suggest other dates. Az-Zarqani rahimahullahu ta'ala anhu, the most famous biographer of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned at least 6 different opinions concerning the date of Laylatul Mi'raj. Allama Abdul Haq Muhaddis al-Dahlawi, the well-known scholars of hadith, has written a detailed book on the merits of Islamic months. While discussing Mi'raj, he said that most of the ulama, most of the scholars are of the opinion that the Mi'raj, the event of Mi'raj, took place during Ramadan or in Rabi'ul Awwal. So dear brothers and sisters, this month, the date of this event is not proven. Even if the date was proven, it would not be permitted for Muslims to single it out and to celebrate it as a night of Mi'raj. Because the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his Sahaba, his companion, did not single it out. They did not celebrate it. Had it been a part of Sharia, the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have told his ummah about it. The Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was most sincere of people. The Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam conveyed the message that he got from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fulfilled the trust he was given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Recall the khutbah, the last khutbah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he delivered on the occasion of Hajjatul Wida, addressing people, addressing his companion, his Sahaba. The Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, innakum satus'aluna anni. O people, ayyuhan nas, innakum satus'aluna anni. O people, you will be asked about me on the day of Qiyamah in front of your Creator. فَمَاذَا أَنْتُمْ قَائِلُونَ. What will be your answer? What will be your reply that time? The Sahaba Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim ajma'in said, نَشْهَدُ أَنَّكَ بَلَّغْتَ الرِّسَالَةِ وَأَدَّيْتَ الْأَمَانَةِ وَنَسَحْتَ الْأُمَّةِ. O Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we will bear witness that you have fulfilled the trust, you have completed and you have conveyed the message that you are given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa addayta al-amana, and you fulfilled the trust. Wa nasahta al-umma, and you have given nasiha, sincere nasiha to your ummah. Then the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam raised his index finger towards the heavens, towards the sky, and said, Allahumma fashhad, Allahumma fashhad, Allahumma fashhad. O Allah be witness, O Allah be witness, O Allah be witness, that I have fulfilled my mission. I have conveyed the message that I got from you. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I completed the trust. And then thereafter, the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again addressed his companion, his Sahaba, and said, Allah, behold, فَلْيُبَلِّغِ الشَّاهِدُ مِنْكُمُ الْغَائِبِ. Those who are present here will convey the message to those who are not present here. Respected elders and brothers, when the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his Sahaba did not consider the night of 27th of Rajab as Laylatul Mi'raj, and they did not consider it as a part of religion, then how do we have audacity to consider it as a part of religion? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala condemns those who innovate, think in the matter of religion, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not ordained. أَمْ لَهُمْ شُرَكَاء شَرَعُوا مَا لَهُمْ شرعوا ما لهم من الدين شرعوا لهم من الدين ما لم يأذن به الله. Or do they have partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who instituted for them a religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not ordained? And the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has given serious warning and severe warning against innovating in the matter of religion. It's recorded by Imam Bukhari and Muslim rahimahumallahu ta'ala anhu that the Rasul of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is reported to have said, Man ahdasa fi amrina hadha, whoever introduced anything in the matter of religion, ma laysa minhu, which is not a part of religion, which is not supported by the reliable resources of Sharia, or which is not in line with the Sharia, with the teaching of Sharia, fahuwa raddun, then this is rejected. Being mindful and being aware of this warning, of this severe warning, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us the right path, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to enable us to follow the lifestyle of His Messenger in every facet of life. And we again ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the month of Rajab and Sha'ban blessed for us and prolong our life up to the month of Ramadan so that we can benefit from its blessing and merits. Ameen wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We have 5 minutes for sunnah.